द नेक्स्ट फीचर ऑफ बिजनेस इज देयर इज एन एलिमेंट ऑफ रिस्क. सो एज आई हैव टोल्ड यू बिफोर ऑल्सो, वेन एवर वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट बिजनेस वी हैव टू टॉक अबाउट द प्रॉफिट ऑब्जेक्टिव एंड दैट देयर इज एन एलिमेंट ऑफ रिस्क इन बिजनेस. सो प्रॉफिट इज द रिवॉर्ड फॉर अज्यूमिंग रिस्क. सो वेन यू गेट प्रॉफिट, वेन यू टेक रिस्क, वेन अ बिजनेस मैन टेक रिस्क. सो प्रॉफिट्स ओके आर अर्न्ड ओनली वेन देयर इज रिस्क. सो रिस्क इम्प्लाइज, सो हाउ विल यू डिफाइन रिस्क? रिस्क इम्प्लाइज द अनसर्टेनिटी ऑफ प्रॉफिट और द पॉसिबिलिटी ऑफ लॉस. सो वेन एवर यू कंडक्ट बिजनेस और एनी बिजनेस मैन कंडक्ट बिजनेस ही इज अनअवेयर वेदर ही विल अर्न प्रॉफिट और ही विल अर्न लॉस. सो दिस अनसर्टेनिटी इज नोन एज रिस्क एंड ही डज एवरी बिट ऑफ हिज एक्टिविटी विद दिस माइंडसेट इन हिज माइंड दैट वॉट एवर ही इज डूइंग इट मे रिजल्ट इन टू प्रॉफिट्स और इट मे रिजल्ट इन टू सम काइंड ऑफ लॉस. ओके सो दिस इज ऑलवेज देयर, इट इज अ पार्ट एंड पार्सल ऑफ बिजनेस. सो बिजनेस एंटरप्राइजेस फंक्शन इन दिस अनसर्टन एंड अनकंट्रोलेबल एनवायरमेंट एंड दीज रिस्क आर बियॉन्ड द कंट्रोल ऑफ द entrepreneur or the businessman. He is not aware whether he will get, you know, profit or loss. So he works in this uncontrollable and uncertain environment. Now why this is uncontrollable and uncertain? Because tomorrow there may be a change in customer's taste. Okay, tomorrow there may be some change in government policy. So today's situation is the most, you know, apt example to understand this. Okay, nobody knew that there will be a lockdown for 2 months. All the businesses are closed, some are working. So all these businessmen, okay, are at a risk of uncertainty. So you can understand with this lockdown situation how business is suffering and they are earning losses also. So this is the uncertain condition that we are talking about, which is known as risk. But again, you will see that tomorrow businessmen are not giving up. They are again, you know, when things are slowly changing into normal, they will again get back to their own business. So business is always having this element of risk. And this risk somehow can be, you know, reduced through correct understanding, through correct, you know, forecasting and through buying insurance. So this is how we have to understand the element of risk feature of business. Next is business creates utilities. Now what is utility? Utility is the power or capability of a product or service to satisfy a human need. Alright, so this is what the meaning of utility is. So business makes goods more useful to satisfy human wants. Okay, it adds time, place, form and possession utilities to various types of goods. Okay, with the help of business only, we can get goods from one place of production to the other place of sale. Okay, with the help of business only, you know, we can change the form of a particular thing. For example, cotton is changed into clothes. So how is this done? This is done with the help of business. Okay, with the help of industries where these things are made. So in a way, we can say that business creates utilities. Okay, and it may create utility. Okay, by changing forms, by changing places, with time utility, possession utility, task and knowledge utility. Next is, there is dealing in goods and services. Okay, so whenever we are talking about business, every business enterprise produces or buys goods and services for selling them to the others or to the customers. So goods may be consumer goods or producer goods. Now what are consumer goods? Consumer goods are meant for direct use by the ultimate consumer. For example, bread, milk, butter, chocolate, biscuits that we all buy. Okay, so these are all known as consumer goods which are consumed. Okay, and it's not sold for further production. Okay, on the other hand, producer goods are used for the production of consumer or capital goods like raw materials, machinery, etc. So again, business deals in both type of goods, whether it is consumer goods or producer goods. It also gives services like transportation services, warehousing, banking, insurance, etc. So that is why the feature of business is it deals in goods as well as services. Alright. And the last but not the least, this feature is known as business is an art as well as science. Why? The question is, why is business considered to be an art as well as science? The answer is, business is an art because it requires personal skills and experience. Okay, today you are very new to the business. Over time you will grow into a very successful businessman because you will gain a lot of experience. Okay, you will have a lot of experience to conduct business. Okay, and earn a lot of profit. So that is why it's a form of art. Now, how it is a science? It is also a science because it is based on certain principles and laws. Okay, there are governing laws for business which businessmen have to follow. There is also science behind it. Okay, when we talk about managerial positions, managerial principles, etc., where predefined science, predefined formulas are there to conduct business. Okay, when we calculate the sales target, we are using some predetermined scientific calculations like this. So this is how a business can be called as an art as well as science. So let's once again recapitulate it. So characteristics of business are, it creates utilities, it deals in goods and services, there is continuity in dealing, there is sale, transfer and exchange of goods and services, profit motive is there, there is an element of risk, it's an economic activity and it's an art as well as science. So this is how you are going to understand business and what are its features. So now, please note down a question that you need to answer. Define business and explain its characteristics or features, okay, or nature. So this is how you are going to deal with this part of the chapter. I hope things are clear. Again, I repeat myself. If any doubt, please note it down somewhere. We'll again discuss whenever we are meeting, when the school reopens. So take care of yourself. Stay at home, okay. And please start studying. Alright. Look into the website. Look for chapter 1 assignments. Look into the questions that I have given. Do answer them. Make a proper commerce notebook because marks are allotted for the notebooks. Take care. Thank you. Now, what is utility? Utility is the power or capability of a product or service to satisfy a human need. Alright. So this is what the meaning of utility is. So business makes goods more useful to satisfy human wants. Okay, it adds time, place, form and possession utilities to various types of goods. Okay, with the help of business only, we can get goods from one place of production to the other place of sale. Okay, with the help of business only, you know, we can change the form of a particular thing. For example, cotton is changed into clothes. So how is this done? This is done with the help of business. Okay, with the help of industries where these things are made. So in a way we can say that business creates utilities. Okay, and it may create utility, okay, by changing forms, by changing places, with time utility, possession utility, task and knowledge utility. Next is, there is dealing in goods and services. Okay, so whenever we are talking about business, every business enterprise produces or buys goods and services for selling them to the others or to the customers. So goods may be consumer goods or producer goods. Now what are consumer goods? Consumer goods are meant for direct use by the ultimate consumer. For example, bread, milk, butter, chocolate, biscuits that we all buy. Okay, so these are all known as consumer goods which are consumed, okay, and it's not sold for further production. Okay, on the other hand, producer goods are used for the production of consumer or capital goods like raw materials, machinery, etc. So again, business deals in both type of goods, whether it is consumer goods or producer goods. It also gives services like transportation services, warehousing, banking, insurance, etc. So that is why the feature of business is it deals in goods as well as services. All right. And the last but not the least, this feature is known as business is an art as well as science. Why? The question is, why is business considered to be an art as well as science? The answer is, business is an art because it requires personal skills and experience. Okay. Today you are very new to the business. Over time you will grow into a very successful businessman because you will gain a lot of experience. Okay. A lot of experience to conduct business. Okay. And earn a lot of profit. So that is why it's a form of art. Now how it is a science? It is also a science because it is based on certain principles and laws. Okay. There are governing laws for business which businessmen have to follow. There is also science behind it. Okay, when we talk about managerial positions, managerial principles, etc., where predefined science, predefined formulas are there to conduct business. Okay, when we calculate the sales target, we are using some predetermined scientific calculations like this. So this is how a business can be called as an art as well as science. So let's once again recapitulate it. So characteristics of business are, it creates utilities, it deals in goods and services, there is continuity in dealing, there is sale, transfer and exchange of goods and services, profit motive is there, there is an element of risk, it's an economic activity and it's an art as well as science. So this is how you are going to understand business and what are its features. So now please note down a question that you need to answer. Define business and explain its characteristics or features, okay, or nature. So this is how you're going to deal with this part of the chapter. I hope things are clear. Again, I repeat myself, if any doubt, please note it down somewhere. We'll again discuss whenever we are meeting when the school reopens. So take care of yourself, stay at home, okay. And please start studying. Alright. Look into the website. Look for chapter 1 assignments. Look into the questions that I have given. Do answer them. Make a proper commerce notebook because marks are allotted for the notebooks. Take care. Thank you.